Welcome to the video news of the week. The Welcome Center on Route 3 in Colebrook has been spared from state budget cuts for another year. Expected to be one of eight centers closed on July 1st, State Senator John Gallis reported this week that the Colebrook complex, as well as Welcome Centers in Shelburne and Littleton, will not be cut this year after the proposed closures were considered by the New Hampshire Senate Finance Committee. Senator Gallis said that the committee recognizes the importance to area tourism that these facilities serve. Meanwhile, the Upper Connecticut Valley Community Coalition is working with the Department of Economic Development to come up with a plan which will see the Colebrook facility operate in a model which will call for more local control with some assistance from the state. The New Hampshire House voted on Thursday to send House Bill 648 back to committee for further study, a move which supporters of the bill say effectively kills it for consideration for this year. House Bill 648, sponsored by Colebrook State Representative Larry Rappaport, would have tightened the state's eminent domain laws, making it more difficult for for-profit companies like those behind the controversial Northern Pass transmission line to be able to acquire private property for utility projects. The bill had passed handily in the New Hampshire House before being stalled by the state Senate.
Memorial Day celebrations brought parades through the area this week. In Pittsburgh, the marching kicked off at 10 a.m. with the group headed to the town park. Meanwhile, Colebrook had their parade at midday with the traditional wreath memorial and recognition. This week, Academy Street in Colebrook began looking more recognizable. Crews who have been working on replacing a retaining wall along the Mohawk River filled in the roadway in front of the Colebrook Academy and leveled it off.
The flying of the mud took place last Saturday in Colebrook as Northern Tire hosted the annual mud run. This year drew what some are calling a record crowd, all on hand to see if the big rigs are going to be able to make it through the mud pit. Once again, the mud show has attracted a big crowd from around the Northeast, and the organizers this year say that it was a particular challenge because of the weather.
But the weather has not been helpful this week.
Yeah?
We couldn't build the pits until this morning.
Oh, my gosh.
And after the driver's meeting, after the staff meeting last night, which, by the way, I have over 40 staff working here today, all volunteers.
Wow.
And halfway through our meeting, it started thundering and raining, and we didn't figure it'd be a good idea to go out and drive metal stakes in the ground, so we did that all this morning.
This is our mud truck.
Right.
We've got a set of 37-inch tires and a set of 43-inch tractor tires.
Right.
And we're running in two different classes. The first time we've ever run a vehicle. First time we've ever run in the mud.
On Monday morning, beginning at about 5 o'clock, high water began rushing down the bog road in Stratford Hollow, washing out bridges and damaging town roadways. We spoke with Fire Chief Chuck Stinson, who is also the Emergency Management Director.
We had substantial flooding that came in about 5 o'clock this morning. We had upwards, it was over a foot and a half, 2 feet of water coming down through this dooryard here. Right. And every town road that's east of us here is got all washed out. We lost two bridges, one on Potato Hill Road, one on Christie Road. Right. And right now they've got crews out there getting the roads passable till tomorrow.
Now this all just came like a sudden amount of water coming down. Where was it coming from? Up?
Rain. We had a heavy rain last night. They're calling for more rain next week, so.
During the height of the flooding, this large tank was washed down into the village of Stratford Hollow.
It was seen floating down through the pavilion over the old playground here, and they pushed it off. It was going to go into the dooryard more, and they pushed it over this way. It came to rest against the house.
The work that you're doing on the roads today, that's going to go through pretty well the whole day today?
Yes, they said they have the roads passable by this afternoon.
Okay. As far as public safety, everybody's okay, their houses?
Yep. This basement here had about 6 feet of water in it. Okay. We rectified this situation. Right. But so everybody else seems to be par for the course.
On Saturday, a Clarksville man lost his life in a two-vehicle crash which occurred on Route 3 in Colebrook, north of town. Police report that Robert Idell, 70, died after a vehicle crossed into his lane near the state welcome area at about 9:15 a.m. Idell's wife, Carolyn, 72, was injured and transported to the Upper Connecticut Valley Hospital in Colebrook and later taken to Maine Medical, where she reportedly sustained non-life-threatening injuries. The driver of the second vehicle, Robert Queen, 74, of Woburn, Massachusetts, was also taken to the hospital with non-life-threatening injuries. Queen was reportedly traveling north when he drifted into the southbound lane and struck the Idell vehicle.
During the Memorial Holiday weekend, Carol Sandhammer Pyers hosted an unofficial opening of her new shop, the Moose Muck Coffee House. At the former lot of Any Blooming Thing Flower Shop, the building has been remodeled by Pyers, which, once opened, will incorporate both a coffee shop and her basket weaving classes.
Well, I've done basket weaving. I've taught for 18 years, wove for 20 plus, and decided to incorporate that with the coffee house. Today is kind of a very unofficial opening. I just decided to kind of invite everybody in since it's Memorial Day weekend, a lot of traffic flow. It's been a pretty steady flow. My dream has always been to have a basket shop and a tea room. So I expanded that to coffee. So I will have tea, loose leaf tea. I'm gonna have specialty coffee drinks with espresso, mocha, latte, cappuccino, and baked goods, and some home baked goods in there too. I haven't only lived here a few years. I know that the muck is kind of where the moose gather, so one of my ambitions is to kind of make it a gathering place in the community. What I hope to incorporate with the coffee house is also a gift basket. If you want to come in and buy bulk coffee and a coffee mug, and we can put it in here, and I intend on building like a gift wrapping station, like a build-a-basket, if you would, to put your items in. Even if you wanted to buy at some of the local shops and bring them in, we could wrap it up as a gift. Currently, I'm updating my website to include more sales. I've always focused it towards teaching classes. So info@basketweavershop.com should get to me, and my phone number is 237-4677. And now my new location is 25 Parsons Street, right next to the post office.
A high of 61 and a low of 40 will kick off the weekend with partly cloudy skies. Saturday rises to a high of 71 and a low of 49, and Sunday has a range of 50 to 69, with a chance of rain and scattered thunderstorms. Playoff games dominated sports this week. Liz Kearney sent us this footage of Pittsburgh and Woodsville girls. Later in the week, Colebrook and Moultonboro girls faced off. Colebrook and Derryfield boys went head-to-head. The Colebrook teams won and will continue on in the playoffs. Thank you for watching the Video News of the Week.